George?
Hello, my fellow sniffers. My name is Marlene McCohen. This is Rocky Waving. And of course, this is
Jenna McCohen,
my sister. Now, before we go on with this Parrot Tip Tuesday, I want to show you something that Jenna has made for Rocky to keep him entertained during this video. Do you want to say what you've made here?
Yeah, we know that Rocky loves toilet paper, paper towels to tear. I don't know if you guys can see. He also likes towels to kind of chew and, I know this is gross, but throw up on. While we're doing this video, I want him to be entertained, stay with us, not get distracted by anything else. So I decided to take some paper towels and I wrapped in them his favorite hazel. This is, what is this? Not hazelnut.
Oh. I think that's a walnut.
Yeah, walnut. Oh my God, I don't know my nuts. So I put them in this tissue so he can, one, tear it, two, kind of have like a hunting, foraging kind of play. I don't think he knows his treats are in there yet, because there are hazelnuts in one of them. It's just a way to keep him entertained. These are colorful and fun, and he can tear like really quickly, but it's something, again, to keep him going. He weirdly likes plastic, so I figured that could be fun for him. And so I just brought a few things real quick so he could focus on playing and be with us in the video without getting bored or walk away or get distracted by anything else.
Guys, it took her only like 5 minutes to come up with these foraging ideas for Rocky. We are outside, and since we're focused on the video, we wanted to give him a lot of activity. He's pretty happy right now. Foraging toys is not the topic of our video, so it's a great surprise that she made this for him, so I'm pretty excited about that. But today, we are going to be talking about how to hang out with your bird outside safely,
right?
Right. Rocky loves to be outside. The first thing I want to let you guys know about having your bird outside is that anything can spook your bird. Whether your bird is flighted or not flighted, once wind gets under their wings, they can take flight farther than you would have ever imagined. We have so much experience with that, don't we, Brad?
We do. It's nerve-wracking.
It's nerve-wracking is exactly what it is. So it's very important that whether your birds are flighted or not, you take all of the same precautions, because birds can get spooked. If you have a great relationship with your bird, you're probably gonna think, well, my bird won't fly away. Of course they won't fly away from you. That's never what they fly away from. They fly away for other reasons. Something frightened them, something flew above them, something excited them, somebody moved something. These are the reasons that birds could fly. A piece of furniture going across them, you know, like if you were just to carry a piece of wood or anything, that can scare your bird. Those are usually the reasons, the unplanned for reasons that spook your bird and you lose him, right?
Right.
Ooh, he found one. Let's see if he finds what's inside it.
I have no idea because he threw the other one on the floor.
Oh, that's what he threw?
Yeah.
What, Rocky? You're throwing things on the floor.
Let's see. Oh, he's going to find it right now.
Oh, this is exciting.
I think he was like, what is that?
He's like, I don't, Rocky, this is some exciting stuff in here.
He loves tissue so much that, like, the thought that there's tissue, that there's, because you see now it's heavy, so he's like, why can't I throw it?
Let's talk about having your birds outside. A lot of people ask me things about how to take care of your bird outside. And as far as I know, here are some of the best ways to handle your bird outside.
Oh God, no, no.
The first thing that a lot of people do, which I think is a great idea, is they harness their bird. But you have to really get your bird used to a harness from the time that you get him or when he's a baby, or practice getting your bird adjusted to the harness, because you don't want to freak your bird out. Scaring your bird and causing him distress can cause birds heart attacks. So you really want to introduce the harness really slowly, get your bird used to it. And then when your bird is used to it, you could take your bird anywhere. You just gotta make sure that they're really connected properly, and then you could take your bird for walks, let him enjoy the neighborhood. And speaking of walks, how does Jersey love some walks?
Oh, she loves walks. When I take the dogs on a walk, I kind of have to whisper it because I don't want them to think I'm taking, you know, one with them, taking them now. But she loves it. But you have to be careful with her. She's not the biggest fan of harnesses, and I think it would traumatize her at this point. Although she does like wearing sweaters, it takes her a little time to get used to the whole sweater idea when we switch it out. So we have to be careful of other dogs, or like if Harry sees something and like kind of pushes me real quick, like, oh, I want to go there. The jolting could scare her, or like even a car driving by, a motorcycle, skateboards, people on rollerblades, all that. Kids are getting excited. Other dogs, when you're walking by a neighbor's house and the gate, and like there's a gate there and the dog's barking, that could be traumatizing for her. So we always try to like, one, keep an eye out on her. And then anytime we cross the street or we hear a car coming, we kind of like interlock our hands by her feet. So her feet are here and we kind of press down and hold her feet down to us. So even if she starts flapping, it's going to be uncomfortable, but she's not going to fall down. She's not going to catch wind. She's not going to like catch wind and fall to anywhere, so like we kind of have control over her. But it's really rewarding for her. It gives her the ability to feel good and see something different and smell something different and be used to the sun. And
she loves it.
She does.
And it's important, if you guys know anything about Jersey, she's kind of one of those birds that'd be very hard for her to take flight because she plucks, so she has like nothing to really give her flight. She has kind of destroyed those feathers. I mean, we're working on growing them back. There's been a lot of improvement. But one thing you should note is that these kind of walks that Jersey goes on with Jenna, they're great for like dusk time, like before it gets dark. In nature, birds love to scout the area before they go to bed. So it kind of goes in tune with their natural body rhythms to take them for a walk at night. So that's a really good thing you can do for your bird to get them healthy and calm and happy. If you want to hang out in your backyard with your bird, you'll notice that Rocky is right here. He is flighted. He is under an umbrella with us, which you guys probably can't see. I would never leave him outside like this unsupervised. That's why I have Jenna in the video. We are both here focused on Rocky and we gave him a lot of entertainment. But I always recommend, if you're going to bring your parrot outside with you, it's a great idea to have his cage outside and keep him locked up so that he is always safe. And we're going to speak about that in a second, because there's other hazards that you do have to worry about even if your bird is locked up. We're going to talk about those in a minute. But I just wanted to go over that second way of bringing your bird outside, which is making sure that he is locked up. And you can add wheels to your bird's cage if there aren't already. With Rocky, I think his cage had small wheels, but he's got a very large cage. So we went to Home Depot and we got bigger wheels and put them on so that we could move the cage in and out of the house a lot easier, because Rocky demands to be outside every day. He loves it. The third way you bring your bird outside, we went over the harness and then your cage. The third way is, of course, outside with you, hanging out. It's best to do that with a harness, but if your bird refuses to wear a harness, just make sure that he is 100% supervised with you and safe at all times. Don't take your eyes off of him. Don't bring another activity that you are doing. I think it's best that the activity is you and your bird hanging out, because believe me, any bird can get flighted. By the way, Jersey is out here right now. That's why we keep looking over there. Yeah, I probably should say that. There. She's very safe. She's in an enclosed area. I'll show you guys a video of that if she stays there. After this, I'll film something for you and put it in. Let's talk about hazards. There's some hazards you may not know about with birds. Rocky's very busy over here. The first thing is animals outside. Let's talk about the number one hazard for parrots outside. That is, do you know what that is?
Is it cats?
Yes, it's cats. Cats are the number one killer of parrots hanging out outside because you don't know who has a cat. Like, everyone has cats roaming around, or there's random cats roaming around. They can be very dangerous to your birds. Rocky's kind of a huge bird, but any bird could be in danger when it comes to a cat. So that's something really important to think about for you to supervise your bird and keep your eye on him. Now, a cat probably can't do much damage to your bird if he is in the cage, but do you know what could?
Raccoons.
A lot of people don't know this, but raccoons gang up on birds in cages. You could have a bird in a cage, and what the raccoons will do is they'll stick their long fingers in the cage, and the bird will get scared and go to one side, and then the other raccoon will come to that side until they tear the bird apart. And I've heard of that happening way too many times. So it's always important that even if your bird is locked up in a cage, you probably don't want your bird to be unsupervised. But I do have a great idea for that. Who supervises our birds when they're outside in the cage, Jenna?
The dogs.
The dogs are not going to let no cat, no raccoon, no squirrel, nothing next to the backyard. What's great about the dogs is that the dogs won't let anyone on the vicinity of this property. So cats in the neighborhood get used to knowing they cannot enter here. There is no way. None of my dogs are gonna let anybody come close to the backyard, let alone the bird cage. So if you do have dogs and you have your parrot outside enjoying the cage locked up safely, it's a good idea to always keep them outside together. That's something that we do, and it's been really, really amazing for us because dogs will let you know about any single thing that's on your property. Our dogs are like great babysitters. I'm like, you cannot be inside if Rocky's outside locked up. Like, you're outside babysitting Rocky.
You know what I see happening? People that you've convinced or like wanted to get a bird, like now be motivated to get a bird. Now they're gonna be like, okay, I need a dog. We need a guardian for my bird.
We need to make dog videos.
Yeah, this is true.
Let's make some dog videos.
There's something I wanted to add about attacks like with birds or raccoons. I don't know much about raccoons, but I'm assuming, I think they can carry rabies. Let's pretend your bird is attacked by a cat or a raccoon or any sort of rodent. Cats also, unfortunately, carry a lot of diseases in their mouth, okay? So if your bird, let's say, gets bitten by a cat, and fortunately, you know, it's not as bad. It may be just like one little puncture. The bird's wing seems like it's gonna survive. Still take him to a vet because there's a lot of bacteria and bad bacteria that could be going through his blood system and him just unfortunately ending his life. Not of a wound or a broken bone or loss of a leg. It's because now he's infected. Never be too safe with birds because, as we all know, birds can literally be okay one day and then the next day completely show 100% of like what's wrong with them because they've been hiding it. So if your bird does get bit by a cat or attacked by something, take them to the vet. Do not hesitate, whether it's midnight, you know, and places are closed. It's expensive, but even maybe from today, if you have one or two birds, it could be a good idea to get insurance because a lot of places take insurance. But I'm getting into the vet stuff. And maybe I should make a video about all this vet stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
For those of you who don't know or haven't seen some of my videos where I explain this, Jenna is a vet tech. She's studying to be a vet, and we're going to make sure that she's an avian specialist. Right, Brat?
Hopefully, yeah. We'll see. It's a hard road.
Because there's not enough great avian specialists in this world. So Jenna's going to be one of those. Back to animal hazards. We have another animal hazard that is very dangerous for birds, and they will keep coming back. Do you know what it is?
Hawks.
It depends on where you live, but you have to be really careful of hawks. They fly around, and even if your birds are supervised, hawks have, I've seen a video of a bird in a bird show, a cockatoo, and a hawk coming down to the lady holding the cockatoo. And she went down like this and saved the cockatoo, but the hawk tried to bite her head. And guys, we have seen a hawk live eating a squirrel, and I got some good pictures of it. And how big was that hawk? How tall was he?
He was huge. He was
like this big.
Yeah, he was two of Rocky, I think.
He was two of Rocky. And in 1 second, there's nothing you can do. So your birds' cages, even if they're outside, need to be under an awning. Awnings, umbrellas. Every time we move to a house, we make sure that there's an awning situation so that a hawk doesn't get wind of the fact that even a bird lives there. Because if they don't get your bird today, they will keep flying around for the one time that your bird is unsupervised. So that's very important to be aware of. If they see your bird even in a cage, they shouldn't know that there's birds here, because they're smart. And what they will do is they will hide in a tree where you can't see them, and then they will dive for your bird when they think that they can. So that's something to be careful of.
Yeah, well, I've seen it with Jersey. She was under our awning, but like she was kind of at the edge, and she was on a chair sitting, just relaxing. I was right there, like it's as if Jersey was right here and I was here. And like, you know, you think you're supervising her and you think you're being a good like bird parent. Out of nowhere, I see like something like swoop down, and like I'm gonna use him as an example. Sorry, buddy. He came down like this. Jersey noticed the hawk, or whatever type of bird it was. It was so fast, I couldn't like say 100% it was a hawk. Jersey turned around, puffed up, screamed and raised up her arms, and then the thing just like went here. She screamed and like zoomed back up. And fortunately, Jersey was like, oh, this is nothing, and then went back to like playing with herself and being normal.
How close was that bird?
Close. Like, look in the camera. There, and then she screamed and then flew away, like where he is. So like,
was it big?
Yeah, because like it was like so fast. She didn't even care. Look, she went back to that. She screamed at it and then went back to that, like nothing happened.
I do notice that Jersey has a great detector for these things, because she can spot Jersey a hawk far away, and she'll start screaming, and I'll be like, okay, we're all going inside right now, because I don't even want the hawks to hear the birds' voices, because it alerts the hawks that the birds are there. So that's something really, really important to know. Now, those are the animal hazards. Those are the major ones. Let's talk about other hazards that could be outside. Can you guess any more hazards?
The pool.
Oh my God, you're like so telepathic.
I swear we didn't go over anything.
You're like so good. The pool. No matter what, you have to be really careful if you have a pool. Birds can drown. You do not want your bird to accidentally get spooked and fly in the pool. Another reason for the harnesses and being locked in cages, because they can land anywhere, including the pool. Sometimes birds can't see the pool as water for whatever reason. So that's something really, really important to be careful of, right? Mm. What else?
Barbecues.
Barbecues.
Dang, you're good.
I know. Barbecues, not only the fire, but the smoke, right? Because, you know, birds should not have smoke, cigarettes. You shouldn't be smoking outside with your birds. A lot of people that smoke like to chill outside, smoke with your birds. These things are hazard for your bird's feathers. When the smoke attaches itself to the bird's feathers, and when he goes to preen himself, he's essentially ingesting all of that. So that's really, really important to be careful of. There's other hazards outside, like weather, for example.
Like overheating.
Overheating. So what should we do if our birds are outside and it's overheating?
Spray them down. You can bring them in.
Misters?
Yeah, misters.
Yeah, you could do some great things with misters. You can go to Home Depot. They have like these amazing misters. I'll put them... Oh, look at the ducks.
Yeah, I saw them.
That's so cute. I'll put a link to those in my products I love store below in my link. Some good misters that we use. You could turn your hose into a mister, like let it come out a little bit. And you could also have a spray bottle nearby, which you cool your bird down every so often with. And like Jenna said, you just bring your bird inside. You really don't want your bird unsupervised in the heat. How do you know that your bird is suffering in the heat?
You like open
opens his mouth, you see that his tongue going up and down, and like his wings tend to be like away and kind of down or just apart, like kind of like
he pants,
you know, like,
yeah,
kind of like a panting. They're usually fine right after, like if you notice it and then you bring them in to cool down or you put water on them, they tend to like recover very quickly.
In any situation, even if you take them into a shower, if you take them outside and it's hot, you have to make sure that you do not let your birds overheat. It's very, very important. If it's cold, I would not let your birds outside. You can have heating situations. For those of you who have aviaries and you want to build something, then you have to really take your time to invest in, make sure that there's proper heating situations. But if your bird is an indoor house bird and you don't have that set up, drafts are very dangerous for birds. They do not take drafts well. You can't leave a door open. You can't have too much air conditioning on them. Rocky is nodding. He does not like it to be cold. If you hear your birds sneezing, make sure to get a humidifier and maybe keep it a little bit warmer in the house. I know what I was gonna say on that note. Every African gray I had has no tolerance for heat, like outdoor heat. I have no idea why. Yeah. It's like they are generally African, but they just do not tolerate the outdoors as well. So I would keep a very close eye on any African grays that you have. Rocky deals with the outdoors much better, so does Jersey. Yeah. So that's something to be aware of as well. Now, if you really want to include your bird, let's say you're a gardener and you like to be outside planting flowers with the birds and the bees, what is another thing that could be potentially dangerous to your bird?
Fertilizer.
Dang. You're good. Yeah, fertilizer, things like that. If you're doing any sprays, bug sprays, anything, you want to really keep your bird away from that. Make sure your bird is safe. Make sure your bird is safe from all toxins in the air. Those are the major hazards that I can think of. Mm-hmm. And the only other thing that I can say to be really important for your bird is to keep him busy outside. Just because he's outside doesn't mean you can forget about him. I think it's really important to do what Jenna did today for Rocky. Bring him his treats, bring him his toys, create something entertaining for your bird to play with. Don't think he's entertained by the fresh air itself. Let him have things to do to enjoy himself, because this is gonna be a great day for Rocky, him hanging out with us right now with all of these toys, making a video. He is so well behaved right now and he's very, very happy.
Is there anything else you would wanna add to that?
Yeah, so when we first got Rocky, it was around the same time we got Harry, or a few months after we got Harry. So we had like a crate, a dog crate. Rocky kind of like going in there and nesting and chewing on it. I think it was fun for him, like when you were a kid and you'd make out of the blankets like a little
fort.
We have like a fort. So sometimes if we have like an old laundry basket, like they go in and they can chew the basket and they can chew the toys in it, or put towels or whatever treats in there. So like it's kind of like a little playground with Rocky. Like that is really cool. Like that's what I like doing with Rocky outside, because I'm not his favorite person. But if I need to watch him and like want to entertain him, I don't necessarily need to interact with him. I could be the like babysitter or the bird sitter. So I don't know like if your bird's into little baskets or crates or burrowing and stuff or towels, but you could definitely do something like that.
Yeah, it really keeps them contained and entertained. I mean, again, if you have issues with an aggressive bird, it can encourage breeding behavior. So if they're too hormonal, be careful with that. But at the same time, if you are not the bird's favorite person and you want to keep him kind of safe and busy, then I think there's nothing wrong with that. I let my birds play with boxes for the most part. They're all pretty amazing with them. They don't really get more aggressive next to their boxes, but that is something to look out for, right?
Yeah.
So that is it, guys. We want to thank you for tuning in to this episode of Parrot Tip Tuesday. And we hope that you will follow us on social media. My links are below. I will put Jenna's links below. If you're a Snapchatter, follow Jenna because she is the Snapchat professional. And if you love Instagram and Instagram story, we are on Instagram. We're also loving Parrot Station. Parrot Station is our members group on Facebook. Jenna loves Parrot Station. She brings me videos every day that you guys are posting. I love it. I love watching your birds. Please come on Parrot Station and show us your birds. And of course, please subscribe, like, share, and comment on this video. And give it a what, Jenna?
A thumbs up.
A thumbs up so that we can make more content for you guys. Oh, and one more thing. If you guys like to see Jenna in my videos, help me convince her to come on more by writing in the comments. We want Jenna.
Oh, yeah.
Right, Jenna? Mm-hmm. I think she has fun doing it, but when she's not, she's like, I'm so busy. I have such a life. I think she enjoys doing it, right, Jenna?
I do. It is very fun.
She enjoys doing it, so help me convince her. I love doing videos with her. This video is probably late, but I think it's a good one. Thank you guys so much for tuning in.
Yay, bye!
Bye!
Are you bird sitting right now?
Hey!
So beautiful.
No cats coming on this property.
What are you getting?